Hi, this is DNA 2.0. I will walk you through the click and drag interface of Gene Designer to the Gene Designer. Let's start by opening up STING file. On your left hand side, you'll find the Library Explorer. Here you can create new elements. There's also a box of existing elements, a box of vectors, and a box of codon tables. On your right hand side, you'll find a workspace. In this example, we have two constructs. One is the T7 snap vector, one is the trim A gene. The T7 snap vector is built from a good 10 or so different elements, whereas the trim A gene is just a single element. As you can see, the annotation for each element is shown in the lower left corner. You can add your own elements, view select elements, edit and delete elements as you please. So let's insert an element. Let's put it next to the 3' stuffer and add new element. Let's make that a DNA element. Give it a name, give it a color and a sequence and some annotation. The new element is now found here. You can drag it to, if you prefer to put it in some other location, just by click and drag, or change the orientation or what have you. And you can also just get into your elements of not to use in the construct and delete this from the overall sequence. You can also take an existing element from, except for say the his tag, put it next to the pet gene, the snap gene, or drag it around as you please. You can change the proportion view so you see the relative size, or just as non-proportional view so you can find all the sequences easily. And drag it to whatever location. You can also, from this pull down menu, start new projects, open existing projects, save projects as, and so on. You can, here's the import and export function. And in the edit view, you can undo, you can cut, copy, paste. In the tools pull down menu, there's a back translate tool, there's a cloning tool, there's a DNA sequencing oligo tool, there's a report function pull down. You can also use this pull down to configure your restriction sites, your back translation profile, motifs, and so on. And so here you see the icon view for that construct in a proportional view. You can also look at the sequence view for these constructs. So here you have the sequence view for the T7 snap, and here's the, this tab is for the trim A gene. And within the T7 snap, because it's a circular plasmid, now you can use the telescope view to orient yourself. You can, on the first level, screen through the plasmid, and on the second level, drill down in certain regions first. And they have the corresponding DNA sequence and amino acid sequence. So you can change the codons as you please by just clicking on them. You can find sequences using the find function, either search by motifs, by restriction sites, or find open reading frames. So let's go find a couple of restriction sites. And click find. Here's a list of restriction sites not found in the sequence. And these ones are found, so let's go and locate this guy. Here's a BSA1 site, here's the restriction recognition site, here's the actual cut site. And you can navigate through sequence the same way. Here's the EA cut and recognition.